In a previous episode, I broke down what port forwarding is, when you should implement port forwarding, and also how it works. But in today's episode, we're going to be breaking down the steps you actually need to follow to implement port forwarding on your router. The example we're going to be using is we're going to be pretending that we're setting up a Minecraft server that we're hosting on my laptop. But keep in mind, if you have other uses of port forwarding, say you're remotely accessing your laptop, you're hosting a website out of your home, or you're remotely accessing security cameras that you have set up, these steps for port forwarding will be the same. Before we move forward here with the first step, I just want to share a disclaimer. If you're looking to actually implement a Minecraft gaming server out of your home network, there will be additional steps you need to do to actually implement that. This is just the port forwarding piece that we're going to be going over today, because that will be applicable to everybody, no matter how they're using port forwarding. All right, I'll be showing these steps on my Windows computer. If you have an Apple computer, the steps might look a little different, but the steps themselves will be just about the same. In order to set up port forwarding, what we need to do is we need to make changes to our router settings. So the first thing you need to do is you need to make sure you're connected to that router's Wi-Fi network or with an Ethernet cable. In short, you need to be connected to the router that you're going to be making changes to. Once you've done that, the next thing we need to do is we need to find the router's IP address that we want to make changes to. What you can do is you can go down here and open a command prompt. You type in cmd. From here, we just want to type in ipconfig and hit enter. All right, the thing we need to look at here is default gateway. That will be the IP address of your router. As you can see, for me, it's 192.168.0.1. And honestly, for a lot of people, that will be the IP address of their router. But you just want to make note of this, because this is how you access your router settings. From here, we can close this out and open up an internet browser. With an internet browser open, we now enter the IP address of our router, which for me is 192.168.0.1, and hit enter. This will take you to your router settings login page. So I'll just enter the password that I identified for my router settings. If you're not sure what this is, or if you have trouble logging into your router and accessing its settings, I previously made a video that you can reference before moving forward. For now, I'll enter my password and we'll go to the next step. I should also note that I have a TP-Link Archer A7 router. If you have a different make and model of router, the user interface might look a little bit different, but the general steps for implementing port forwarding should be about the same. All right, here we are on my router settings homepage. One thing you might want to make note of before we move forward is that once you've implemented port forwarding, you might want to test it. And in order to do that, you'll need to enter the public IP address of your router. What we entered here into the search bar to access our router settings is its private IP address. But your router also has a public IP address. That's what's shown here where it says IP address. It lists a different public IP address for your router. I've obscured it for security purposes, but you'll want to write that down just so you can test after you've implemented port forwarding. So when you're implementing port forwarding, what you're really doing is you're mapping a specific port on your router's public IP address to forward traffic to a specific port and private IP address on your home network. That port and private IP address on your home network is obviously the device that you're accessing through port forwarding. But in order for it to work properly, you need to make sure that that IP address of the device doesn't change. The way that it normally works with your home network is your router will automatically assign private IP addresses to the devices in your home network, using a protocol called DHCP, Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. And what happens with this protocol is that these IP addresses are not static. They will change if the device disconnects from the home network and then reconnects at a later time. We don't want that to change, because if we're hosting a website, we always want that to have the same private IP address. So that way traffic doesn't get forwarded to the wrong address if our web server falls off the network and another device gets assigned that IP address. So basically, that was a lot of words. What we need to do is we need to assign a static IP address to the device that we will be accessing through port forwarding. Again, in this example, we're setting up a Minecraft server on my laptop. So this laptop needs to have a static IP address that we know will never change. In order to do that, we need to go to the Advanced tab of our router settings. From here, we go to Network, and then DHCP Server. And as I mentioned, your router will automatically assign IP addresses from a given pool. So here is the pool of IP addresses that it will automatically assign to your devices. When you're assigning a static IP address to a device, you don't want it to be in this DHCP pool because you don't want your router to accidentally try to assign it to a different device. So in short, what we're going to pick is we're going to pick 192.168.0.50. That's outside of this range here, and that will be the static IP address of my laptop. So what we need to do, address reservation. We want to select add. Here you need to enter the MAC address of the device that you want to assign the static IP address to. We can find that back on the basic tab. My laptop is connected to my router wirelessly, so it's under wireless clients. And I know the name of my laptop is Skynet. So here's the MAC address. We're going to copy this. Go back to the advanced tab. Network, DHCP server, add, MAC address, we're going to paste it in here. The IP address, this is the one we want to statically assign, so we're going to choose 192.168.0.50. Description, because we're hosting Minecraft on it, let's say it's Minecraft server. We want to enable this entry, select save. So now, this device, at this private IP address that we've assigned to my laptop, which we're calling the Minecraft server, it will now always get that IP address and no other device will be assigned that IP address. That's the first step for implementing port forwarding. Now we can move forward to setting up a port forwarding rule to forward traffic to this device. If the steps for assigning a static IP address to my laptop were a little bit quick for you or you need more detail, I created an entirely separate video that talks about how to do this, so you'll want to check that one out as a reference. For now, we're setting up the port forwarding rule. So what we need to do in the advanced tab once again, we need to go down to NAT forwarding, and then we need to go to virtual servers. Here we want to create a new rule for port forwarding, so we select add. And here's where you might need to do a little bit of research in order to enable port forwarding for the given device. I looked up for a Minecraft server the settings that you need to implement for port forwarding. I know that the service type, it's an HTTP connection, so we're going to select HTTP. The external port, so this is the default port for a Minecraft server, that's 25565. This might be different depending upon what you're hosting out of your home network. Whether you're hosting a website, you might need to select 80 or port 443, but you'll be able to find all this information online here and it will help you fill out this port forwarding rule. I know for me personally, I just went to the Minecraft website and it told me the steps I need to follow to implement port forwarding. I'll include that link in the description if this is what you're looking to do. The internal IP address, that's the static IP address we set for this laptop, 192.168.0.50. The internal port will be the same as the external port for our Minecraft server, 25565. Protocol. The choices here are TCP, UDP, or all. I looked this up online. If you're hosting a Java Minecraft server, you use TCP here. We want to enable this entry and we select save. All right, there we have it. Now our port forwarding rule is in place. Another thing I should bring up is with the default Minecraft server configuration, the port is 25565, but I can change that to a different port if I want. So if you set up your Minecraft server to use a different port, those are the ports that will go in here for the external port and the internal port in your port forwarding rule. At this point, you have your port forwarding rule, you have your static IP address for your device. Now what we want to do is restart both your game server, so in my case this would be my laptop, and my router just to make sure these settings take hold. Now that you've rebooted your devices, you can actually check to see if port forwarding is implemented correctly. What you can do is you can go to Google and then you type in port checker. This first result here, portchecker.co, is a good one, so you can click into that. From here you just need to enter the specific information for your home network. At the beginning of these steps, we recorded the public IP address of our router. That's what you want to put in here. The port number, there's a drop down here. So if you're hosting Minecraft on the default port, you can select that and it will change the port number to 25565. And then what you do is you select check and it will tell you if the port is open or not on your router. When running the port checker, if you get a notification saying the port is closed, what might be the case is the device you're setting up port forwarding on might have a local firewall and you might need to create a rule for that. For example, my laptop has a firewall. I need to also open a firewall rule on my laptop in order to allow my Minecraft game server to be hosted on my laptop. In order to implement a firewall rule, we first need to go to the control panel. So you go down here, control panel, system and security, Windows Firewall Defender. Here you can go to the advanced settings. Next, with port forwarding, we're talking about traffic that's coming in from outside of our home network. So we want to look at the inbound rules. We want to create a new rule. We want to open up a port. We'll hit next. It's a TCP port. Again, this is the connection that's used with port forwarding. Java Minecraft server uses TCP. Does this rule apply to all local ports or a specific port? We're using a specific port, 25565 for our Minecraft server. Select next. We're going to allow the connection. We'll use the default settings here and select next. For the name, we'll use Minecraft server rule. We'll select finish. And now we have that inbound rule in place on the device that we're implementing port forwarding for. So go back to the port checker after you've done this, run the test again, and you should get a good result and it should say the port is open on that server. Once port forwarding is working properly, you can share the public IP address and the port that you're using for port forwarding. You can share that with your friends that are outside of your home network so that way they can access your Minecraft gaming server. A word of caution here is you don't want everybody to know what your public IP address is. You don't want to broadcast to the world on a website or on a chat what your public IP address is, because then you're just opening up your home network for people to poke around and hackers to try to get in and hack your device. Because you're allowing external traffic into your home network with port forwarding, there's increased security risk, so you just want to be mindful of that. If you were able to follow these steps to successfully set up port forwarding, I'd love to see that in the chat. And I'd also love to hear about what you're setting up port forwarding for. As always, thanks for checking out this episode from Network From Home, and we'll catch you on the next one.